Randy, who's the best receiver to ever play in the NFL?
You talking to him.
I mean, I get it all the time. You know, who's the best? Who's your best receiver?
Well, we're going to get that in.
Because with me and Hatch, I had to hang up on Hatch on this probably like about a month or so ago.
he had cried, baby, because he knew I was right, Mossy. He knew I was right.
I tried to tell him, I said, Randy's good. I said, but I'm more of a complete receiver than Randy. I said, I did everything in the book. I said, Randy is good for taking the top off. That's what people know him for. I said, yo, he's had a couple of slants and things of that nature that he takes to the house.
A couple?
Yeah, but he ain't really, he had, in my opinion, there's not most of his touchdowns, they bums.
Okay. Now we're getting into it. So this is what we go do. I'm gonna start you before we get into that conversation. I'm gonna give you the criteria on who's the better receiver between T.O. and Moss, because there's got to be some type of criteria, right? It's not about speed and size combination, because we know you guys have that, and there's other players in the NFL that had that, right? So the first criteria is, do you show up in big games? Obviously, right? It's got to be one, right? Second criteria is big catches or your big highlights or your big plays, right? Third is how many times do you guys get double covered, right? And then 3B would be, did you guys still perform versus the double coverage, right? Five would be Hall of Fame corners. What did you guys do versus other Hall of Fame corners that you went up against when it was one-on-one, right? Six is, of course, your hands or your playmaking ability versus defenders. This ain't counting when you guys are wide open, right? You guys rarely wide open anyway. But again, when the defender or two defenders are on you, do you still make the play? Seven is your run after catch or your like playmaking ability when your ball is in your hands. Number eight, catches over or between two or three people. Number nine, play in numerous systems with numerous quarterbacks and still put up numbers.
That's me all day.
And number 10, where the defensive coordinator put you as the number one priority to stop you that week. Were you the number one priority?
That's been everywhere in my career. This is how I wasn't so in tune with statistics and things of that nature. Bro, I didn't even know what five-time All-Pro. I didn't really know all of that stuff until, obviously, you get nominated for the Hall of Fame, and then they start rambling off your stats. And they go, oh, he was five-time All-Pro.
All-Pro's a big deal, yeah.
Yeah, but I didn't really know any of that stuff. So I was like, at one point in time, I was like, okay, I just want to make the Pro Bowl. I felt like, okay, if I got a nod to the Pro Bowl, then, okay, I'm making some noise. But when you think about doing it everywhere that, you know, being productive everywhere they played, I know that I did that because I outplayed and I was the number one receiver. Even when teams, especially end of my career, when they didn't even think that I would be the number one receiver, I outplayed my last 2 years. I outplayed two guys that was with their quarterbacks for pretty much the entirety of their career. In Buffalo, Lee Evans was there. I outplayed him, of course. Second half of the season, that was when Ryan Fitzpatrick got in that quarterback position. Bro, I had like 800 and I think 30 something or whatever yards, but I didn't get a bulk of those yards until Trent Edwards got hurt and then Ryan Fitzpatrick came in. So then I started to ball out. I outplayed Lee Evans, like I said, the second half of the season because I had a quarterback that knew who to get the ball to. And then you fast forward a year after that, I go to Cincinnati. Chad's been with Carson Palmer for, at this point, like 9-10 years. I go in there a month in training camp. They didn't even sign me initially in March. They had Antonio Bryant. They brought him. He was 10 years younger than I was. So that's what they went with. I was 37. He was 27 at the time. And that was like, I went and met with Marvin Lewis, the head coach or whatever. We went in for the dinner or what have you. And then on my way back to the airport, the guy told me, he goes, man, they signed Antonio Bryant. I was like, what? So I was like, all right, cool. So I'm still a free agent. Months ago, they go into mini camp, OTAs. Then I find out he has an injury. They bring me into training camp. I go into training camp for a month. learning to play. That was a number system, different system than I've ever really played in. But I was like, okay, cool. I'm just going to make it work. I had to learn. Obviously, you know, Carson Palmer brought me in. He saw me work out over the summer in L.A., told the guys that I look good. They brought me in. And then, again, the rest is history. So you think about, like I said, being able to really flourish in every system. Like I said, I was in control, and Randy can attest to this. You don't really matter about who's the quarterback or whatever. If you got confidence in your ability and you know what you can do, if you got a head coach, an offensive coordinator that puts you in the right position and you're in the right system, it's just like I said, we were alluding to earlier, you know, having just say both of us on the team. If you have the right offensive mind that can put both of us in a position to succeed, then you're going to be productive because you're so confident in your ability. All we need is the ball. Yeah. You just need the quarterback to get the ball to us, and we're going to do what we do. So that's what I did. I didn't really worry about, honestly, like the quarterback situation. The only time that I started to worry about that is when I was in Buffalo, because I'm like, I never really played with a young quarterback like Trent Edwards. And prior to coming in or them signing me to that one-year deal, they said, yo, we want you to come in and kind of help groom this young quarterback along. And at that point in my career, I'm like, yo, this is the first time I'm ever hearing this. I'm like, yo, this is like one of those conversations. I was like, okay, you're kind of on your way out. They want you to just come in and groom a guy. I'm like, I never really heard that type of thing before. So I'm like, all right, cool. I ain't really tripping. I'm just going to ball out and do what I do. And so that's it, man. I mean, everywhere that I went, I basically adjusted my game to not only the systems. Most of the systems that I played in was sort of West Coast based. But I just, like I said,
you still put Jerry Rice as your number one receiver.
Yeah, I mean, I think statistically, yeah. I mean,
I didn't ask you statistically.
Yeah,
Jerry Rice is the best receiver to ever play in the NFL, in your personal opinion.
Yeah, I think.
Randy, who's the best receiver to ever play in the NFL?
You talking to him.
Already. Okay. So
I put myself first. I'll put T.O. second. Mm-hmm. And I think Jerry's probably third or fourth. I'm talking about dominating the game and changing the game of football. I don't live on statistics, because if you live on statistics and live on championships, that's all political.
Mm-hmm.
You've seen guys cut, but you've seen guys released or cut from a team just by a couple words in the media. You've seen guys given contracts or you've seen guys not given contract just because the color of their skin. So I think that you gotta throw politics out of the game of football and look at the impact of what each individual was able to make in the game of football. You know, I don't discredit anything that a guy like Marvin, Jerry, Terrell has done for the game. But when I look at the game of football and my impact of, you know, being able to come in as a rookie, leaving hot with all the double, with all the triple coverage coming in, I really don't like talking about being the best wide receiver of the game, because I never set my goals into being the best. But I think that at the end of the day, you know, to look at a lot of accomplishments from the guys that they think that are at the top, I mean, rightfully so, T.O. could be one, Jerry could be one, anybody else could be one. But I think that when I look at myself, and I'm not looking at any highlights, just talking about the game of football, of being able to come in as a rookie, set a record for being the highest scoring offense in the National Football League, and then being able to go back 10 years later and do it again. Mm-hmm. So just a lot of the impact of the game of football that I look at. I'm really not a big statistics guy, really not. And I really don't like the argument about who was the best. I mean, jokingly, of course, I'm going to say myself, but I really don't like the argument of who's the best in the game, because respectfully, I give myself the nod, because if you're not going to bet and believe in yourself, then really, who are you? Mm-hmm. But I look at the impact that guys like Terrell has made in the game, man, and that's why I feel that, you know, when dealing with changing the game of football, when you see that they're putting two guys over me, they're putting two guys and three over Terrell itself. So, like I say, I look at the game, and it kind of makes me feel a certain way when we boil down the discussion of who's the greatest of all time. I really don't like talking about it because I really feel a certain type of way because I really don't base it upon numbers.
It's not the numbers.
No, it's not. It's really not the numbers. And I just look at the impact of the game, man, because I had 2 years in Oakland. 1 year I fell off, and that's where all the talk about I lost the step, I lost the speed. So, and then the year TO that you're talking about, that I was on three teams in 1 year. So realistically, I had a 14-year career, but if you subtract those 2 years, I really had a 12-year career putting up those type of numbers. So I don't really like to talk statistics when talking about, you know, greatness or who's the greatest of all times. I just look at impact of players. I don't care if it's the guard, offensive line, or wide receivers, man.